The second type of research under category of process. So we have here two figures. So this figure in your left is the process of qualitative research method. Okay. And on your right is the process of quantitative research method. So in other words, research, when categorized according to process, it can be qualitative research or quantitative research. So from the keywords qualitative and quantitative, the background or the description is very simple. So when you say qualitative, it involves quality or kind, of course. So the quality of phenomena that you are handling as a researcher. So your research is designed to find out how people feel or what people think about something, about your topic of interest. So it is applicable and very significant in behavioral sciences, but it is also significant and applicable in pharmacy research, most especially in clinical research or in pharmacy practice researches, because we are dealing with patients. And patients, we have drug-related problems that are starting from our patient's perspective, and that is patient compliance. So we tend to study also the behavior of our patients in relationship to their compliance to drug regimen. So qualitative research also aims to discover underlying motives of human behavior. As I have mentioned, there are underlying behavior when patients does not like to comply with their regimen. Or in our self, also as pharmacists or as a student, what are the underlying behavior why we tend to act or why we tend to self-medicate if we already know what are the consequences of it? Why we tend not to do patient counseling, or we tend to do what is not expected from us? So this qualitative research can be done right now in our online distance learning following descriptive type of research. Okay, so the data that you are going to gather from this type is in the form of words. It can be very verbose in order to describe correctly the feelings and the happenings in the community, or it can be in the form of picture or object. So that is the qualitative process. Now moving on the other side, we have here the quantitative data collection. So when research is categorized according to process, the quantitative type is the one that follows more strict process or more defined process, because it deals with measurements. Okay, it deals with quantity, it deals with amount. So the data that you are gathering later be on expressed in quantity. So you must have a research instrument that would produce accurate data because you are going to measure it. So research instruments such as survey instruments. So these questionnaires or these tools will collect data that can be processed through statistical tools or statistical calculations. As I have mentioned a while ago, it can be in the form of frequency, average, or mean, median, or mode. So from the picture here, we have face-to-face, online, mail, and phone. These are the modes on how you can collect this data. And in our new normal in online distance learning, quantitative research is feasible. Okay, so quantitative research can be done online. You can send your questionnaire online. You can do face-to-face interview virtually. You can send email or you can call through phone if internet is not available for your respondents.